about three. Then you want to get them on top of each other and cut them about an inch to an inch and a half wide this direction. You don't want to spend too much time on this, so you want to act quickly on this and get this tedious, boring part out of the way. So again, we have three layers. And these are going to be a little bit thicker. So these are going to be about palm size like this. And I think you should cut, again, two sets of these, just to be sure you have enough. So here's one set, and I'm gonna do the same thing. You get three of those rows and then cut them into about palm size. Today we're gonna be making a hand mold out of plaster. So you get plastic gloss, and the first thing you wanna do is get something like Vaseline or something like that on your hand so that the plaster mold releases from your hands. I got plenty of Vaseline on there, and now you want to start. So I like to start with small pieces like this for the fingers, and you just want to put it right through the finger area like this, and then smooth it out. The plaster is very soft and malleable right now, but once it activates, it will have it will dry out and get hard. So the water activates it, and it makes it super soft at first. So you want to smooth the plaster as you go. Now, if you do not put that Vaseline on, it won't come off very easily at all. So it will get stuck, and all your little hairs will get stuck to it. So you'll get an instant free waxing job, which you probably won't want. Okay, so now I go to larger pieces. I try to take out as much water as possible. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that right over my wrist area and the other previous plaster gauzes there and smooth it out. I'm not going to put a lot here because I'm going to go ahead and cut it there later so I can release my hand because I'm doing this by myself. And plaster takes about 15 minutes to set and start getting warm and hard. So you'll know and you'll feel it because it'll get warm and you'll feel it getting rigid. So most places I'll put two layers, but in this area here where I want to cut it, I'll try to put like one layer so that I can cut it easily and be able to remove my hand out. You can also do masks this way, but you have to make sure that you protect your eyes and protect your hairline area if you're going to use your face. I've done it myself before, and it's a lot of fun. I think I'm going to do this diagonally. Try not to wrap too tight so that you can release your fingers later. Just want it loose. Get close to your fingers. Classes where we did the face masks, and boy, that is a lot of fun. Students really liked it. It was one of their like favorite projects always. But with everything that's going on in the world, that's just not the best of things right now. So this, I think, is more appropriate since you can do this on your own and you won't necessarily need help like you do with the mask. With the mask, I have my students help each other in the past, that's what I used to do. It's a lot easier, it's a lot better, but I mean, you can totally do one yourself by yourself, but it's just, you know, a little bit more challenging to have to do something on your Facebook, so. And a last finger. Alright guys, so it feels hard enough now. I'm going to go ahead and cut it right now before it gets too hard. So I'm just going to cut very carefully. Wait, now I've cut it out and I'm just going to wait here. Alright, I waited about 4 minutes after I finished to make this cut, and now I waited another 4 minutes or so. It should be a lot stronger, it's a lot firmer. And you just gotta wiggle your hand out. There's my thumb, now the rest of the fingers. It's coming out slowly. So just be patient and move it slowly, carefully, so you don't break the form. And I'm almost there. Remember, the more you pull your fingers, that's going to be harder too. So, you know, make sure you don't curl your fingers that much. Unless you're going to cut more, perhaps in the middle. Alright, so, just my hand out. Took a little bit of wiggling and gently pulling right opening. And here is the hand. The Vaseline really helped. It didn't get stuck. And all you want to do now is basically cut a few more strips. Out to that area. And just simply put the plaster over. The plaster on the hand is not completely clear, so it's not completely hard, so it'll be a lot easier to finish it up right now. You can still finish it later if you really needed to, but I like doing it right away so that it just blends better. If you do it later, you'll have to wet the plaster that was dry. So just remember to wet the plaster, the dry plaster that you'll be putting the new pieces on. So you'll need to wet the hand first and then add the pieces. There you go. Put another piece here. Make it a little bit stronger right there. Here is your very quick 15-minute pan. Ooh, I didn't see that, but yeah, we're gonna have to fix a finger here. See, that happens, and that's okay. So, fix that right now. There we go. you have any issues, there's a little bit of breakage there. Not much breakage, but more like compromise there. It's still settling, so I'm just pulling it back up a little bit, and it seems to be fine right there. That's from when I was pulling my hand back down. But other than that, everything seems to be good, but now that I pulled it up, everything looks great. Nice and smooth again. There you go, you have a plaster hand ready for whatever prop you might want. Next, I would paint it, and I'm gonna go ahead and paint it, but I'll probably be showing that on another video.
Love you guys, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And in appreciation for you staying this long, here is the cutest picture of a lilac-breasted little bird I hope you enjoy. Have a great day.